Welcome to KidsAcademy.mobi.
Hello, everyone. Let's open the worksheet. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. You can find the link to this app in the comments below. Today, we're going to be looking at a worksheet called Construction Zone Math, Equivalent Fractions. But what's an equivalent fraction? Let's take a look. If we had a fraction 1/4, well, before we even draw a picture of 1/4, let's identify what each part of the fraction is so we know exactly what we're drawing. 4 is the denominator, or the bottom number. That shows you how many pieces a fraction is broken up into. For this fraction, I know that it's going to be broken up into 4 equal pieces. The top number is the numerator. The numerator tells me how many of those pieces are shaded in. In this fraction, 1 is shaded in. To make an equivalent fraction, we want to make a fraction that has the same amount of space shaded in. So for example, an equivalent fraction to 1/4 could be 2/8. To show this in a picture, instead of cutting our fraction into 4 pieces, we'll cut our fraction into 8 pieces. Now, instead of shading 1 piece in, we'll shade 2 pieces in, because the numerator is 2. If you look closely at these pictures, or you can imagine them on top of each other, you'll see that they take up the exact same amount of space. The same is true when you look at fraction bars. We're just looking for fractions that might have different numbers, but take up the same amount of space. Let's read the directions and get started with our worksheet. Use the fraction model to complete the statements below. Circle the correct numerator. Let's look at our first example. 1/4 and blank 12ths. We know that 12 is the denominator here, as is 4. So that means in the first bar, there are a total of 4 pieces. And because 1 is the numerator, there is 1 piece shaded in. In our second fraction, we know that there is 12 pieces in total because 12 is our denominator. But what's the numerator? Let's count the shaded in pieces to find out. 1, 2, 3 bars are shaded. So I think 3 is the correct numerator. Let's circle 3, and if we look closely, we'll see 3/12 takes up the exact same amount of space as 1/4. And that's what we're looking for in equivalent fractions. So 3 is the correct numerator. Let's take a look at our next example. In this problem, we have 2/3 is equivalent to blank 9ths. Again, in our first fraction, 3 is the denominator because there are 3 pieces in total. 2 is the numerator because there are 2 pieces that are shaded in. Let's look at our second fraction and count the shaded in pieces to see what the correct numerator is to make an equivalent fraction with 9ths. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces shaded in, which means 6 is the correct numerator. 2/3 is equivalent to 6/9ths. And we can see that 2/3 and 6/9ths take up the exact same amount of space. So 6 must be the correct numerator. Let's take a look at our last problem. Our first fraction is 4/8, and our second fraction is blank 16ths. Let's identify the numerator and denominator in the first fraction. In the first fraction, the numerator is 4. That means there are 4 pieces shaded in. The numerator is always the top number. The bottom number is our denominator. That tells us how many pieces there are in total. And in total, there are 8 pieces in our first fraction. In our second fraction, there are 16 pieces in total. But what's the numerator? Let's count the boxes to find out how many 16ths need to be shaded in to make an equivalent fraction to 4/8. Well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pieces shaded in. And if we look, 8/16 takes up the exact same amount of space as 4/8. And that means that 8/16 is the equivalent fraction, meaning that 8 is the correct numerator, or top number. Remember, boys and girls, the numerator is the top number, and that shows you how many pieces are shaded in a fraction. And the bottom number is the denominator. That tells you how many pieces are in total. Thanks for watching, boys and girls, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.
like us and subscribe to our channel. Find links to our apps and comments below.